performance or fight of the night, it's gonna be something. Fireworks, you don't want to miss the fight. In my weight class, I'm gonna be a problem, and now I feel like I'm the problem.
Benoit Saint-Denis, welcome to TNT Sports, welcome to UFC 295, and welcome to New York City. This is your first time in New York? You've been here before?
My third time. I have a good friend of mine who got married in Philly with a Philly girl. In 2016, it was the first time that I did a back and forth from Philly to New York. Great city, happy to be there.
This is your first time at Madison Square Garden. Did you manage a visit last time?
Yeah, first time for Madison Square Garden. First time fighting in New York, so great. I like Vegas, but I love New York.
There's something a bit special about Madison Square Garden as a venue. Was it ever on your bucket list to one day fight there?
Yeah, especially having done already a couple of Vegas, I absolutely wanted to do my next card in the US in New York, and having the opportunity was great.
Your career so far, even though you've only been competing for 5 years, has been nothing short of incredible. Are you surprised your career has moved so quickly, the opportunities have come so quickly?
You know, when I started MMA in 2019, I told myself I have 2 years to go to the UFC because I got paid for 2 years after the military, you know, after my service. And
you had savings.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. So I was expecting that, but I was fighting like six times the first year. I got to go to the Brave Combat Federation. I did great there. And despite COVID, I was able to fight like two times a year, which is great. And I'm grateful for Brave Combat Federation to make it happen, to have fights despite COVID. Not everybody was fighting. The UFC was like the exception that had shows all the time. And then I make it to the UFC, and 2 years and a half after starting MMA, and it's been great. And I think it's all about training hard with intelligence, with a good staff, and being on a mission. Me, my family, and all my staff to go to the top.
You took your first fight at late notice up at welterweight, out in Abu Dhabi. Things didn't go your way, but since then, back in your real weight class at lightweight,
yeah.
Four straight wins, four straight finishes. You're making it look easy.
Yeah, it was short notice against the top 15 welterweight, so tough challenge, and I had only 2.5 years experience of MMA, of practice and competing. So, and the guy got popped 3 months after the fight. So still waiting for justice to be done, getting my no contest. But you know, it's a long debate. But yeah, it was a tough fight, but a lot of experience. Despite being a tough fight, a lot of experience. I learned from it, I loved it, and despite being hard, I loved it, and I was okay, I'm not gonna let it go, and I'm in my weight class, I'm gonna be a problem, and now I feel like I'm the problem.
Yeah, you are the problem, because yeah. You're finishing everybody, and like, we've been fortunate enough to be with you in Paris as well. I think globally people are starting to realize who you are and what your capabilities are, but back in France, back in Paris, something a little bit special happens when you make that walk and when you compete inside that octagon. The atmosphere was incredible.
Yeah, I love it. I'm blessed to have the support of the French people. I have so much support in my country. People were behind me, behind the family adventures that I have as a fighter, and with my wife, wife doing all the communication. My family is a lot involved in it. Also my staff, my friends, they are all pushing me to the highest level of competition. And I have a lot of love around me. So it gives me the opportunity to train very hard and to concentrate on the fighter's journey.
How has becoming a father changed you? You had a daughter in the summer.
Yeah.
How has that changed you? I can't, because you're,
yeah,
in real life, you're quite an intense guy. Inside the octagon, you're a very intense guy. I can't imagine Benoit changing nappies and looking after the baby too much.
Yeah, it's difficult. It's difficult, but I love it. I enjoy it. It's like a couple of kilograms of happiness to have our baby. So, and she will be watching at Madison with...
She's coming over.
Yeah, my wife, my father, and the baby, of course. Yeah, we are a happy family, and thanks to the UFC, I'm able to do it full time. And it has gotten a family adventure.
The baby's arrival, does that help with you to have a break from training, to being able to switch off from the intensity of mixed martial arts every single day, where you get in, you put the cartoons on, you relax? Is that helping you?
Yeah, holidays are very important. To take a break as a fighter is important. I think some people, a lot of fighters, they train hard all year, all the time, and they're getting a bit depressed. Also in mixed martial arts, you don't get as much fights as in Muay Thai, in Judo, or in English boxing. So you have to take your time to train hard at the good time of the year, before the fight, on the rest of the time, training with intelligence, getting better in your weakness, getting your high points even higher, and enjoy the journey. And take your time also for your family, and of course holidays and family time is important.
We've spoken about the noise, the intensity, the atmosphere when you fight in Paris, but of course this weekend you're taking on Mafra Voller, who's a top 15 ranked guy in his hometown, so you could argue the noise will be for Matt and not for you.
Yeah, of course, it will be the opposite, but you know, MMA got legalized very late in France, so we are used to be booed by the crowd, having fought a lot in the beginning of my career outside the country, especially against local guys. And yeah, I'm gonna enjoy it. It's a booster, but a different kind of booster. And yeah, I'm expecting it to be a tough fight and a great show.
A couple of your recent fights, a lot of media have made you the underdog. That narrative is changing now, and this weekend, heading into the fight with Matt, it's not necessarily you're the underdog or he's the favorite. Everybody's predicting fight of the night. It's going to be fight of the night. These two guys are just going to go boom, and they're going to guarantee a bonus. How do you see the fight playing out?
His style and my style is, of course, it's going to be fight of the night. Yeah.
That's your big prediction to the fans?
I have no doubt about it. Performance or fight of the night, it's going to be something. Fireworks, you don't want to miss the fight.
Top 15, here we come.
Hey, here we are.
Absolutely. Benoit, go well Saturday.
Thank you very much, Nick.
Brilliant.
Cheers.